Join us as we check out the bustling city of Darwin, the capital of the Northern Territory. With so much to see and do and the history that surrounds Darwin, you'll never get bored. Thanks so much for your support. Sit down, relax, have a drink. Peace be the journey. We are down at the waterfront in Darwin. We're just going for a scoot.
Where the first bombs are up
in
the wall.
Here. Beautiful day. Water is beautiful colour. Quite warm. So that's where we were last night to watch the Matildas play.
Hey Chick, there's a croc.
Pardon?
There's a croc.
Where?
Down there.
In the water?
Yeah, just against the rocks there. See it?
No.
Just down there. Black thing.
Oh, I see it.
It's a black croc.
It's a black croc. Funny. So this is the port of Darwin, and this is where the first bomb went off on the 19th of February 1942. Very scary, I would imagine. The Mindle Beach Sunset Market is in the heart of Darwin. This multicultural market sees over 200 stalls, ranging from food stalls offering incredible local and international cuisine to stalls with arts and crafts. The market also supports and provides opportunities to Darwin and regional Northern Territory artists from all genres of creative and performing arts to showcase their talent. The combination of amazing food, arts and culture and an amazing backdrop where we'll join hundreds of locals and tourists to watch the spellbinding territory sunsets. The markets are on Thursdays and Sundays from 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. from April till October. So we're just about to go into the Defence of Darwin Museum. It's $20 to get in for an adult. 0 to 5 year old kids are free, and 5 to 15 are $10. And veterans with a card is $15. So it's all about the bombing of Darwin and World War 1 and 2 and some of the other wars as well. I know there's some stuff in there about Vietnam. So we will show you more through it. There's also plenty of parking in here and just out on the road there for vans if you want to bring it in. And easy to turn around. Not in the car park obviously, but out on the road's easy to turn around with a van. It's out on East Point in Darwin. Darwin, the largest population centre in northern Australia, was considered a vital asset in Australia's defences against an increasingly aggressive Japanese in the 1930s. Its port and airfield facilities were developed and coastal defence batteries constructed. The outbreak of war in the Pacific resulted in the rapid enlargement of military presence in Darwin, and it was used as a base from which to deploy forces for the defence of the Dutch East Indies. In January and February, these forces were overwhelmed by Japanese landings, usually preceded by heavy air attacks. On the 19th of February 1942, Darwin itself was bombed. Japanese fighters and bombers attacked the port and shipping in the harbour twice a day, killing 252 Allied service personnel and civilians. On the 3rd of March, Broome in Western Australia was bombed. In succeeding months, air attacks were made on many towns in Northern Australia, Western Australia and North Queensland. The Japanese air raids on Darwin on February 19 involved collectively over 260 enemy aircraft. Subsequent raids in April, June, July and November 1942 and March 1943 were carried out with forces of 30 to 40 fighters and bombers. Between the large raids were the smaller operations by groups under a dozen Japanese aircraft. Most of the raids occurred in daylight, but there were some small-scale night attacks. The 64th and last air raid in Darwin occurred on the 12th of November 1943. In total, there were 97 air attacks on North Australia, and enemy reconnaissance over the region continued through much of 1944.
Sing away.
What a wonderful world.
Bunkers protecting Darwin Harbour. Look at this side. This is a 9.2 inch gun. It's not the original one. The originals were cut up and sold for scrap, which is a shame. But yeah, the walls on this thing are massive. Up and down inside, they're over half a metre thick. You can see the roof here. That roof's got to be, oh shit, I don't know, 8 foot thick. And that's a side wall there. Runs right around the back. That'd have to be a metre and a half. So yeah, it should take some bombing. But these guns were only ever fired practice rounds. They were never fired in anger. Yeah, there's one here. It's one on the west. This side. There's one on the west side. There's also another one over the back there, which we'll go and have a look at. You can go in, similar to this one, and a heap of other buildings. It's outside the compound, but we'll go over and have a look at that. Well worth a look, this military museum. It's yeah, probably the best one I've seen outside of Canberra, the War Memorial.
So we bought some frosty fruits the other day. I'm not really sure what happened to them. This one's mine.
Oh, they're tart.
You'd be right. Take another we'll see your face.
The inside's mixed with the outside. We'll be right back.
is out on East Point. Once upon a time it was all military. It's bunkers. I don't know what them green little things are, them hut things. There's a big military plane that just went past. So we have just arrived at the Botanical Gardens in Darwin and I'm going to go for a scoot along the waterfront and then a scoot around the gardens and then over to Fisherman's Wharf. Might have a cold beverage by then. Get our cool little scooters out. 35 degrees here today, so quite warm. Show you on the way. In the botanical gardens, that's an African boab. It's huge. Got paths all around in here. Oh, feels like there's midges or mozzies though. Webs everywhere here. Oh, cool. This is the African section. If you didn't guess. This one's for my mum and dad. Idiot. This one's for mum and dad. Check out the size of that desert rose. It's massive. Not quite in flower yet. That is huge. You, yeah, Wally. Check out the size of this boab. There's Bernie. That is huge. This actually takes you into the kids' playground, this gate, so we'll go in and have a look. So this is a playground. Check out this cool treehouse. Yep. My child's going to go up there and have a look, I would imagine. Yep. Yeah, that's very cool. Big tree. A little tiny slippery dip, but... Here's my boy. yep, that's where they put the monkeys. So we're back in at the Botanical Gardens. We just parked the car and we saw this tree. It's unbelievable. Very strange, but very pretty. It's got like the flowers all on the branches. Strangely. So well kept in here, it's lovely. Nice breeze too, because it's very hot today. So we were just talking to some people, and they told us to come over here to this big tree and have a look up in there. Look what we just found.
All made of scrubby.
Bloody big python. I don't know if you can see it on there.
Bigger than four, maybe.
Oops. Look at him, he's massive. Hopefully he stays up there. Pretty sure I know why Bernie brought me this way. Because he came here yesterday. He was gone for quite a few hours. So I reckon that top place is probably where he went to. So we're staying at Lee Point. the way we came down. Can you head down that way? To the Surf Life Saving Club at Casuarina. This mangrove boardwalk's pretty cool, so I'll show you when we get there. This is a mangrove boardwalk. It is. Temperature is so much cooler in here. Very cool. Have to be careful when it's the big tides. I think 2nd of September there's going to be a 7 point something or other tide, so this will probably have water all in here. Not a bad view in here. Just coming to a steep bit. Not sure I'll drive down that, I'll probably walk. Might get Bernie having a stack here. No issues. So this is the Sandy Creek watch post. It's right on the ocean. Morning, so we've woken up quite early this morning, out the door by 7 a.m. Huge tide today, 7.5 or something it is, so we've just come down to the mangrove boardwalk to have a look. That's a pretty big tide. By the sounds of it, there is water across the little boardwalk, so I'll go have a look.
This is the little mangrove bridge. That we come across the other day, you'll see in earlier shots. And, it's completely out of the water, and now it's 100 mil under. I'll take a walk in there in a minute. This is yeah, this is a walkway through the swamp of the mangrove. It sort of feels a little bit eerie walking in here. There's crocodiles around. But all the locals are walking through, so... yeah. Hopefully nothing comes out at me. So this is the actual creek. Like I said, you'll see in previous videos. This is where, yeah, it's about, I don't know, 2.5 meters. 3 meters down to the ground the other day. So, yeah, pretty cool. So we'll head down to Nightcliff and have a look down there. See the difference with the tide. It's actually still slowly coming in. Top of the tide was, well, now 7:30. It's probably about 20 to 8. Watch out. Very cool, seeing the difference in the tides. Big tides up here.
Bern just went for a walk through it. It's not very deep, but yeah, she's well and truly covered. Actually see the tide running out. See the tide running out there?
Huh?
See the tide running out already?
Tide's what?
Running out.
No, it's still running in.
That isn't...
No, that's out.
Oh.
That's the beach that way.
Oh, okay. My apologies. It's actually coming
it's
in.
Still, yeah, it's only just turned top of the tide.
I thought that way was out.
Cool. Oh, no, the tide didn't turn back at all.
Beautiful day here today. Not a ripple. Best part of the day. That's how quick the tide's going out. Join us next week as we have part two of Darwin and we hit Old Sydney Town. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Peace be the journey.